Thank you, and good morning, Republicans. It's great to be in Brainerd. I'd like you to imagine, if you will, a year from today. Picture the Capitol Dome, brilliant white, against a steel blue Minnesota winter day. And I'd like you to imagine a big yellow moving truck slowly moving away from the Capitol with the final boxes marking the end of Mark Dayton's political career. Now, what happens next starts right here. Minnesota cannot afford to lose another winnable election for Republicans because there's so much at stake. We can't afford to turn control over to the out of control once again. That's why I want to start talking about winning. You know, the year I won for the Minnesota House, I was the only Republican to defeat an incumbent Democrat that year. And since then, I've won every time in years that have not always been great for Republicans in a district that doesn't always vote for Republicans. Now, you know what? It's extremely important that we win. I didn't do that in the last year by running away from my party. I had a Trump sign in my yard, and somebody said, you know, you're in the suburbs. You better get rid of that Trump sign. You better run away. Well, I didn't run away from my party. I ran with my party. I didn't run away from my principles. I ran on my principles. I ran about 11 points over the president, but I didn't run against him. And you know what? That sign was in my yard on election day, and I was proud. Next year, I don't want us to gather and say, you know, we could have won that governor's race if it wasn't for Minneapolis, and if it wasn't for St. Paul, and if it wasn't for Duluth, and if it wasn't for Chisholm. You know what? It doesn't work like that. You got to win the whole thing, and that's what we're going to do. But we got to energize this state. We got to bring them together around a clear vision. And I tell you what, Minnesotans are desperate for leadership, they're tired of excuses, and they're hungry for results. And we've got those results, and we're going to offer it to them as a Republican ticket in the next election. So my plan to win involves unifying the whole state. And I can't unify the whole state unless we unify as a party. I respect what you do as a delegate. I respect the work of this party. I am going to outwork everybody else to earn your support in June. But if I don't get it, I'll support whoever does because I am a party Republican. You know, when people ask me why I'm running, I can boil it all down to two people. A woman from Hugo and a guy from Thief River. A couple of years ago, I talked to a lady named Katie. She said, you know, here's the problem. The Republicans keep taking the state back from the Democrats, and the Democrats take it back from the Republicans, and we never get it. You know, she's right. And she is the person Donald Trump was listening to when nobody else would. She is we the people. And if you think she's not a Republican, you're wrong. You know, I heard this over and over at the state fair this year. I heard it from Ada to Zambrota. And after the state fair, I got in my car and I said I need to do some more listening. We pledged to get to 87 counties in 87 days between Labor Day and today. And I gotta tell you, we didn't do 87 counties in 87 days. We did it in 84. And I'll tell you what, a man from Thief River shook my hand and he said this. And these are the marching orders. He said, don't tell me who you're going to beat. Tell me what you're going to do. Well, here goes. President Trump, he said, if you can do health care a better way, you do it your way. Mr. President, we're going to take you up on that offer. We're going to do it our way again. I offered the bill to get rid of Minshew. I passed it off the House floor. As governor, I will sign it, and I will rid Minnesota of Minshew forever. Can't wait for a governor to have their back again. If you're on the freeway, if you shut down the Capitol, if you shut down the Mall of America, you are going to jail. It should have taken Kate Steinle to say that we need to look at sanctuary cities. And I say to Minnesota, if you're a sanctuary city, stop being addicted to subsidy because you're going to run out of it. You know, a brand new legislature legislator said, what's it like to be at the Capitol during budget time? I said, well, close your eyes. Imagine yourself trapped in an old country buffet with Michael Moore. That's what it's like. You know, we need to get a handle on spending, and the only way to do that is to cut spending, and I've proven that I can do it. I cut $1 billion out of a single bill, and until we get a handle on spending, we are in trouble. And I'll tell you this. Steve Krasnowski's bill on refugee resettlement needs an up or down vote until we find out the costs and guarantee the safety and security of our state. We will not ask our sponsors to pay rather than be paid. We need to pull the plug on refugee resettlement until we do. I was born in this state. I was born on the Iron Range. I grew up on Rice Street. I've got the best wife in the world. We've got three great kids. We are going to take it across the state. I thank you for your work. I thank you for your work as a delegate. I'm asking for your vote. My name is Matt Dean, and we are going to make a great